Hey YouTube, in this video I'm going to show you how to get your concerts on your Spotify page. So this is what it's going to look like when we're done. You can see I have my artist pick, my show in Minneapolis. If you'd rather have your artist pick be a song or an album, you'll still be able to get your show on your Spotify page in this on tour section. As you can see, my Minneapolis show is here, and it says where tickets are available. We can click it, you'll be able to click here. And this is actually where you buy tickets. So to do this, we're going to be using a site called Bandsintown. I'm pretty sure there are other sites that'll let you do this, but I use Bandsintown and it works pretty well for me, so that's what I'm going to show you guys. So you'll want to go to artist.bandsintown.com. This is the Bandsintown for Artists website. And from there, you'll click Claim Your Artist Profile. So you'll sign up with your artist email and make up a password. Now you'll put in your name and your role. You're probably an artist, but you could be any of these things too. You'll have to verify your email with the code they send you, and then you'll have this page. From here, you can click Get Started. And you're going to claim your artist page. So I already did this, and it says you can type in your artist name or Bandsintown artist page URL. So check Bandsintown to see if you already have an artist page somehow. I didn't, so I just typed in my artist name and it created a page for me from there. So if your artist doesn't exist, you can click add your artist to Bandsintown. You would type in your artist name and then hit submit. Once you have an artist page, the next step is to link your Spotify. So go here to profile, and I recommend filling this out with some details about you as an artist, but it doesn't really matter. For now, you can just go to links. Under links, you'll see Spotify, and you can fill this out with your Spotify artist link. In my case, for DG the Artist, that'll be this link, just whatever link shows up when you go to your page on Spotify. Should start with open.spotify.com/artist/, and then some long string of characters. So you can paste that here. You can paste your other links too while you're at it if you want, but that's not necessary for getting your shows on Spotify. Once you've done that, you're almost done, just go to events. It'll probably say you have no upcoming events, so you can add an event. It's probably gonna be a concert, probably at a venue. You can put in the venue name. You'll choose the start date, start time, end date, and end time. Click next. Put in the name of the event, a description, lineup, which might just be you or it might be other artists too, up to you. And then you can add the set list. That's not necessary. I haven't done it for my event personally because I'd rather keep that a surprise, but up to you. Finally, here's the important part. You're gonna want the ticket link. So in my case, I have two ticket links. I'm performing at the Cedar in Minneapolis, so they have a page for me on their website where you can buy tickets. But that's actually through Eventbrite. So it goes through this Eventbrite page where you can also get tickets for the same event. So it's up to you which one you wanna do. I personally think it looks way cooler to put the one on the venue's website if you have a similar situation. So that's the one I linked, but totally up to you. And then you choose the type of tickets it is. So whether it's regular tickets, pre-sale, VIP, all these different things. And then once all that's done, you can click next and then click publish. You can also save it as a draft if you want, or even schedule it. Once you've done that, now it's the hardest part. Wait up to 48 hours for the changes to go into effect. So I don't remember exactly how long it took for me. I know I made my event on Bandsintown on a Friday, and then it was definitely up on Spotify by Monday. It might have been up on Sunday too, I can't completely remember. If it takes more than 2 or 3 days, just make sure you have the right Spotify link. It should eventually go through. And another thing you can try is Bandsintown has this tutorial on their website for how to get your concerts on Spotify and in a bunch of other places too. I'll link this in the description so you can follow along in case maybe any of the steps I've shown have changed. This is the tutorial I followed and how I learned so I could make this video for y'all. And after a few days, it did work for me. Now the final thing to do if you want is to add it as your artist pick on Spotify. Once the show has actually gone up. So you can go to your Spotify for Artists page, which you should already have access to if you're watching this video, then click View Profile in the top left, go to Artist Pick, scroll down, and you'll see Concerts as an option. So if you click that, it'll actually show the concert nearest to whoever's looking at your profile. In my case, I only have one upcoming concert, so it's gonna be the Minneapolis concert. You can add a message, and you can add a background image if you want to, and then click Done, and save. Artist picks expire after 180 days, just keep that in mind. And now finally, if you go to your artist page, you'll see this artist pick with the show. It'll link to Bandsintown. And then finally, you'll be able to buy tickets at whatever link you gave to Bandsintown. One thing I've noticed is the background picture doesn't actually show up for me in my artist pick, nor does the tickets on sale now thing that I wrote. It does say the artist pick can take up to 24 hours to update, but the show itself shows up immediately. Just the background picture and the blurb don't show up. I'm not sure if maybe Spotify has those things disabled for concerts, but they still let you do it in the back end. I'm not really sure why that would be the case. If anybody knows, let me know in the comments. It might just show up in another couple days or so. If so, I'll let you know in the description. But yeah, that's it for this one. If this video helped you, let me know in the comments. And if you want to return the favor and you're going to be in Minneapolis in July, pull up to the DG the Artist show. You can also follow me on Spotify or on Instagram or here on YouTube. I'm actually located in the DC area, so whenever I do shows around here, I'll announce it on this channel and on Instagram. So drop a follow and maybe you'll see me live one day. Anyway, thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next video.